Hi gamers, I'm Cyber Settler, and today we're playing Space Engineers. Today we are picking up something that I've done in other videos, and this is this has to do with the thrust offset. So you know that in Space Engineers it doesn't matter where you place your thrusters, they will always the game ensures that they are always aligned to the center of mass. And there's a mod that lets you offset that the force that the thruster exerts over the ship considering the center of mass. So I will place the mod link in the description below, and let's look at I have this ship, so this is a miner. This is a very basic miner ship, and I've made it in such a way that it's symmetric. So this is what matters when you're considering the center of mass. If you have played, for example, Kerbal Space Program, it lets you see the center of mass and also the center of thrust. So where are your thrusters applying force over your vehicle? And Space Engineers has a functionality where you can see, in fact, the center of mass. You go here to info, and there is this option here, show center of mass. So we're going to check that. And now we should be able to see the center of mass. There it is. Let's get out of the vehicle and look at it from outside. So you see that like pink sphere there. That's the center of mass of the ship. And when you have this mod, I'm guessing that originally the developers of Space Engineers intended for the thrusters to have an offset from the center of mass, and probably at some point they saw that it was it added complexity to the game that they didn't want to have, and they removed this. But I'm not sure about this. It's just a speculation, because in fact you can display the center of mass, so this doesn't have any, I don't know, for me it doesn't seem that to have any functionality, unless of course you're using a mod. So I fell there. So the thing is that when you have this thruster offset, what you have to take care is that your thrusters are placed symmetrically around the center of mass. Because what that does is that whenever you move around, your ship won't rotate, right? So one thing is, for example, that you want to strafe left or right. If your thrusters are not, for example, this, if you want to strafe left or right, we are talking about these thrusters here, the one here and one at the bottom there, they will activate. And so if they are not, if the center of mass is not aligned to this force application, then it will tend to spin, right? It will tend to make this roll movement, for example. And the same applies to the other thrusters and other movements, like if you're going up or down or whatever. Also, in the case of this miner ship, we don't have any gyroscope. So the gyroscope in Space Engineers lets you move, or like rotate your ship, controlling it with a mouse. This rotation, you control it with a mouse. But If you don't have the gyroscope, then you are not able to rotate the mouse. So this is based on a real thing. It's sometimes it's called reaction wheel in space technology. And these reaction wheels, they will move a spacecraft with mechanic force. So you don't need, in fact, any fuel to be spent moving the rotating the craft, because the reaction wheels will do that. And it's they only need to be powered, but they don't consume any fuel. But if you I made some research about this and found out that these reaction wheels are quite heavy, and they are not used when in spacecraft that come and go, that they are intended to have a short journey. Like, for example, the space shuttle, it didn't have any reaction wheels to control the attitude, so it used RCS, like this reaction control system with thrusters. It used propellants to activate these thrusters. So this minor ship, particularly, it doesn't have any gyroscope. So the idea is that you will use the thrusters to move around. One particular problem, for example, when you're using the miner, if you are mining, then the weight of the ship is changing, because ore is going into the ship. And as you can see, I placed two containers, but they are aligned with the center of mass, so I don't expect much trouble there. It's just that the only thing that we have to be careful is that both containers have more or less the same amount of ore. And here I have other ships. These other ships, they have gyroscopes, so I don't intend to use the thrusters to move around, like to rotate the ship. I have this command module that is loosely based on this Eagle Transporter command module from Space 1999, the TV show from the 70s. And also I have a Millennium Falcon here, a model I made following also kind of loosely the design of the Millennium Falcon. And you see that it has this it displays several center of masses. I'm not sure why is that. And it has a warp drive at the back. So we will test those as well. But first, let me go to the mining ship. Let's make a test, like try to mine something, and then we will come back and test the other ships. So I have mapped the in order to use the thrusters to control the attitude. It's you need to override them, otherwise the game will take control of the ship. So here we have placed the thrust override to 25.8 kilonewtons. I think 25 is enough. And I mapped the thrusters. I created all these groups of thrusters, like the ones going backward, forwards, up, down, all of them, right? The pitch, the yaw, the role, all of them are mapped. So you need to do this if you are planning to use them as RCS. Okay, so let's see. One important thing here is to display this artificial horizon, because there you can see the velocity vector. This important when dealing with this thruster offset. So I mapped each thrusters to a number. So currently the numbers are following more or less the layout of the numpad, but I'm not activating it from the numpad, but it helps me memorize which direction is which number is assigned to which direction, because the numpad, somehow the layout of the numpad is like a grid, and it helps memorize. I think there's another mod for key binding, but currently it's just the normal binding of Space Engineers that I'm using here. Okay, so let's see. Yeah. So let's go up. Sometimes this happens. Sometimes I have to like change this, and I don't know why, for it to work. Okay, wow. It needs to like now I'm applying like 20 kilonewtons. That's a lot. So I had problems there taking off, and it seems to be the problem is that I need like 25 kilonewtons to move this thing. For example, for the Apollo, the quad thruster that it used, each of them would apply like 400 newtons or so of force, like 100 pounds more, a little bit more than 100 pounds. And I don't know why it requires so much power, but it does. Okay, but now we are off. So we are now navigating with the thrusters, and okay, so the idea is that we will go to the side of this asteroid to mine something. Let's do that. We will go to one side. So it's very hard to like. You will see me like struggling a bit to get the right movement. So there we are now. We applied a lateral movement there. I'm moving to the side of the asteroid, and we will mine some ore. I think I saw some iron down there. Yeah, well, this you of course most of you won't play Space Engineers like this, but this is like a challenge. Special challenge that I took to try to drive the ship like this. Now we'll try to stop the ship moving sideways. Once I get so there, am I activating the side thrusters? Oh, now I think I'm moving in the other direction. I don't want that. But the fact that I'm activating the side thrusters and the ship is not making like this roll movement is what we want. This is a hard thing, and if you look at the ship, it has like these weird things on top, and this is because these weird structures, and this is because I tried to compensate for the landing gears, and it has other things going around to compensate the asymmetrical parts. Oh, I think I'm drifting away too much. So I think I see the iron now. Let's rotate the ship to one side. So in order to rotate the ship, I have to activate the thrusters again. And it's really hard sometimes to stop it from rotating. At least space engineers tend to add some damping to rotation, so I can sometimes slow it down in such a way that it will eventually stop. But otherwise, it's hard to stop it. Okay, so we are like facing the right way. If we see the velocity here, we don't see it, so we are not moving in this in the direction we're facing, in fact. Soon enough we will be doing that. The first thing is I want to go start going down. Let's go down, and there we go, downwards, and you can see the iron there, right? Like this iron. Ah, wait, I think I activated the wrong. We need to go forwards as well, and there is the velocity vector. If you see it, it's in the middle of the upper screen, the middle upper screen. This little circle with the lines, two at the sides and one at the top. This is the velocity vector. So we are moving forwards, and it mostly is matching or heading. So let's keep moving forwards and downwards. If I go downwards, strange, the velocity vector is not like showing. Okay, I think we need to also somehow fix our attitude. It's a bit, so now we are. Okay. Now you see that the velocity vector disappeared, is because we are not moving forward anymore. But we have to fix that attitude, and it's not easy. Okay, and we need to head one thing we could do to have a more precise control over the rotation is to decrease the power of the thrusters, because it's really difficult to head in the right way. Oh, wait, not there. Okay, we are spinning in the wrong direction. There. Okay. So now I think we should go forward. And a little bit upwards. One thing I forgot to do is to map the the drills. So here, basically what we will do is just crash into the rock, basically. So let's map the drills. There, we collided. And now let's map it. Yeah, to the three. And we will activate it. So I don't expect, you see the center of mass there. I don't expect the center of mass to change unless we have, like, if both containers they contain more or less the same amount of material, then I don't expect the center of mass to move. So currently we are having 7,000 iron ore in one of them, and in the other one is 5,700. Okay, so thousand and 5,000. Okay, so I think I will stop now. We need to balance the amount here. So we will take it's almost 6,000. We need to take 1,000 here and move it there. So 1,000 there, and we have more or less the same in both sides, right? So we have 7,000 here and 6,900 something here, so it's around the same. We could move like 80 like 80, and now it's exactly the same, 7,000 and 7,000. Okay, so that's it. Now let's return with our cargo. hopefully this will not be that difficult, and we're going to try to land on the pad. And first we need to go backwards, so that's with the one. Now we are separating from the rock. I will show more the external view so you can see the thrusters activating. And once we're clear from the I saw some little bit of spinning, maybe, not sure. Okay, but it seems to be behaving in the right way. This is the test. Like we have now like a loaded miner. This is a big issue. Like when you have such a vehicle with thrusters offset, then you want to keep the symmetry. But one is not only at build time, is also when you load it. So when you load it, you want to keep the load symmetrical. And here you can see that we are spinning a little bit. I don't know if we have another, because the mass is even here. We don't have anything else. Okay. So let's move forwards. You see that we spin now. I don't know why. And you can see like the center of mass is a little bit to the left for some reason. I don't know why. Because we have exactly the same load in both sides. So we're going forwards now. We should go up. And you see there we have a little roll movement. We're rolling to the left. And this is because the center of mass, you can see it here, it moved a little bit to the left. Maybe if we move, I don't know which one is which container is which. If we move again more or. And another thing is, not only the ore will change the center of mass, but if we have like hydrogen, or if we have ice loaded in the generator, as the ice is consumed, then this alters the weight distribution in the ship, and this is a challenge. So, and this also the ship has all these connectors, and these connectors can carry load. So you must be careful not to, if you have load on the connectors, you have to balance it, right? So these are the challenge. Different challenge you have to face. Okay, so we need to move to the left and forwards, and there you have like this little rotation movement. Yeah, but I think we can just do it fine if we let's go down a bit. So the idea is to land in the platform. I think I need to rotate. Yeah, I think that's. So rotation is with the 7, yeah, and with the 9. There. Okay, so we are almost there, but I will make this. Better. There we are. So touchdown. We're back. So that's the miner. I will upload this to the workshop. I will leave a link in the description below. So I think this is like a very simple ship. And oh, I not there. I left it on. It's a very simple ship. I want to show you guys some things that are going on here. So even in the in these weird structures that are trying to like compensate for the lower structures, we have like this heavy metal components blocks to further balance the weight. So this took me some time, and this is a bit like a trial and error thing. I added these tanks, these hydrogen tanks, because so the vehicle has some extra fuel. Is good when we have like extra fuel in the ship. So I thought that I would add this, but I had to compensate playing around with these blocks here. And I want to show you, for example, in this case, this command module. You can see that the center of mass is pretty well placed. It's a bit to the front maybe, but otherwise you see that the center of mass is aligned to the RCS clusters, right? So this is what we always want. This ship we can only enter through this opening here. Otherwise, we cannot really go into the ship. It's very cramped inside. I have this oxygen tank here, so you just from the outside you just click F here, and with a 1 we close the door there. So I have binded the opening and closing of the door to this to a key, to a number here. Okay, so currently what do we have? What I do usually is that I disable the dampeners. And when I want to, in this case, for this particular vehicle, the thrusters are not overrided. So that means that the game controls the thruster action depending on the keys I press with this WASD. But this one has a gyroscope, like unlike the minor, this one has a gyroscope, so I'm not controlling the attitude with the thrusters, but still we have this thruster this thruster offset. So it's not like we don't have the thruster offset, it's like is that we are not controlling the attitude with the thrusters, but with the gyroscope. And still, if you don't take care of symmetry with the mod, with this thruster offset mod, you will have strange effects. So we put the dampeners off. Let's take it for a spin and let's go. So now we are going up. Forwards, so you don't see any strange. Well, here we have a. No, it's fairly stable. Now I can move my ship. So, without the dampeners, you can rotate your ship, and this won't change your velocity vector. So here you can see that we don't see it. I have the velocity vector just in front of me, so let's go under the asteroid. Let's go forward first, and now the velocity vector appears. Now we go downwards. It disappeared because we were going downwards, but as soon as I apply some forward thrust, then it will appear again. This is just a panel, what I have just in front of me. This is just a panel, and you can set it to display the artificial horizon. This will display the velocity vector. So let's go under the, and you can see that like the velocity vector coming up, right? But we're still going down. If we want to go up, then we hit space bar, and now we're going up. But we are over the. Now we're going backwards. Okay. So let's go back to the asteroid. Where is it? I lost it. Ah, there. Okay. Let's go forwards. So you see, here you can see that when I go up, it makes this slight movement, like, how would I call it? It leans forward. This because the thrusters are not entirely aligned to the center of mass. You see, I go up and it goes a little bit. The nose goes down a little bit. So this is because of that reason. But this wouldn't be like hard to fix. That means that there's a little bit more weight at the front and at the back. But if you add additional blocks or replace a light armor block with a heavy armor block, then you can fix this. So, but this adds like an additional element to the game. You, of course, this limits the designs that will work. You have to keep in mind this symmetry thing. But as you can see, there's like this not entirely symmetrical ship right there. It's the Millennium Falcon. But surprisingly enough, this ship is somehow it has some. It's not so bad, let's say, the symmetry. Let's test it. Let's take it for a spin as well. Well, this video is not about the Millennium Falcon, but I will show it to you guys anyways. So there's that's our command module right there. Let's go for the Millennium Falcon. So as the original design, it has like this docking port to the side. We go in here. Let's close the door. This is an airlock. That part right there is an airlock, and it works like an airlock. So here we are inside the Millennium Falcon. I have this survival kit and then cargo containers here. This is the cargo area. This is where you can see also the warp drive back there, and this is a cargo lift. There's a door that opens up, and this is an empty room. This room is following somehow the original design. Here is the door to the cockpit, and here we have like the this launch area. Here we have a kitchen, the bathroom, and here we have like sleeping quarters, two beds. And here is you can have a view to the exterior through this window. What else? Well, here is another airlock, and this is the other docking port of the ship. This is a programmable block right here, and this side, this is like this service area, and you can go down there and you will have like this area where they used to hide contraband, and it's powered by a nuclear reactor that you can fit it here with fuel. And here's an armory, and again this is the cargo area. So more or less it's following like the design. But let's go to the cockpit and take it for a spin. So let's take out the dampeners. Let's go up. So you can see here that I'm going up. It doesn't, it's not spinning, right? It seems. Let's go sideways. So again, it doesn't seem to be making this jaw movement, right? So in principle, I think it's working. It has also a gyroscope, so I can move it with a mouse. If I activate like the main thrusters, like the impulse thrusters, then I would look, there's some a little bit of rotation. It was with the mouse. Okay. But it's then hard to slow down with a small reaction. So it's not, That's the reason why I often have the RCS decoupled from the main thrust. In this design, I would just have a button like a binding to turn on and off the impulse thrusters. So I'm reducing the lateral movement here. Let's go forwards. We will see that the bottom center screen is displaying the artificial horizon. So it should display the velocity vector as well. So let's go forward and we will see the velocity vector coming up. Still we have some lateral movement there. So there we went behind the asteroid. We will be spinning because otherwise it's very hard to slow down with the small thrusters we have at the front. So there we are slowing down. Let's go up. We're still going forward. So here at the bottom you can see this hangar doors where we deploy the cargo lift, and it has turrets at the top and the bottom, like following the design. We need to go that direction. And we are going back. So the advantage to have like the game control your reactors is that you can press C anytime and it will stop your ship. It will compensate for any. Now I press C, like to compensate for all the movement that like directions, and I can just stop. And this is a problem when you don't have, like, the game is not controlling you don't have this flight assist, these dampeners, then it's difficult to stop. And you have, like, you are continually moving, usually. So, for example, like, what I did there, my trip was, I lift off, I went for mining. And the way I stopped is I somehow bumped into the asteroid, and going back I will stop with a landing gear. Okay, so we are back. Let's go down. Oh, I crashed. I crashed. That's not good. This is the because I was not in the cockpit. Okay, but you get the, well, I think it's a challenge. And I thought, like, with this thruster offset, that I will have trouble with the Millennium Falcon, because the Millennium Falcon is not symmetric, right? And since it's not symmetric, then I would have trouble. But it turns out that I think one thing is that it's very big, so it has a lot of mass, and probably the maybe. I thought like this cockpit section will throw the ship out of balance, but I don't know. I didn't plan this build to be like to have a centered center of mass, but maybe the layout inside somehow compensated for this difference. For this, asymmetry. It's an additional level of challenge, an extra level of difficulty, and well, I like it. I because then you cannot do anything, right? Like you have to think through your designs to be symmetrical. Okay, guys, but I think I will leave it here. I hope you like the video, and see you in the next one. Let's go outside. So this is Cyber Settler signing off.